it's Jules. Welcome back to my channel. Today we did a somewhat chatty get ready with me. So if you're not into that, don't watch this video. If you have not subscribed to my channel, please do go ahead and hit that subscribe button. It's like right down below. It's in the red box. It says subscribe. There is a lot of random rambling. So, but if you are into that, grab a snack. Come hang out with me and my dog who was chilling there. She will be there in the next clip because she was there. But if you do like these videos, go ahead and just keep on watching. I wonder if Bailey is just gonna be in all my videos in the background now. She's so stinking cute. I don't really have a plan for today. I was just gonna kind of get ready and film whatever happens. So I guess I'll just go ahead and get started. I did purchase this Wet n Wild PhotoFocus Matte Primer a few days ago, and I have worn it a couple times with the PhotoFocus foundation, and I've been really liking this. It says that this is like the same formula as the old one, but just a new packaging, but I didn't know the old packaging was matte, so that's why I didn't buy it, I guess. I usually use two primers whenever I wear makeup. So I just put this one all over my face because typically my whole face gets oily. And then I like to use this Luminizer primer by Dr. Brandt that I got in a BoxyCharm. I don't really think it luminizes as much as it claims, but I just like it for the, because it says pores no more. And I always have like really big pores like right here. So I don't know that it necessarily helps a whole lot, but I do like to just put primer there. So, how's everybody doing? I feel like I've been super busy lately with work and everything, and I haven't really talked about this on my channel. I'm trying to get into school for makeup and skincare aesthetics, and it's been so hard for me to remember to actually call the school. I don't know why. Like, today's Monday, and they're open today, but the time that I realized that I could actually call them, it was already 5 o'clock, and I know that I can't call them after that. So I'm like, what's wrong with me? I need to call the school so I can get into school, and then I need, in order to get out of my job, because like, I mean, my job's okay, but like, I don't want to be doing what I'm doing for like the rest of my life. So we need to go to school. We need to go to school for this stuff because I like it. I'm not going anywhere today, so things might get a little crazy, but I don't know because we're just kind of starting out right now. I don't know. I'm so indecisive. When I don't have anywhere to go, I'm like, what do I do? Do I just like, I don't know what I do. So, like I said, I've been using the PhotoFocus foundation with the PhotoFocus primer. So, I guess we'll just kind of use this. Because I wore it to a couple concerts the other night. And it actually lasted really well. I had, like, not used this foundation in a while. Because I was trying out other foundations. And I was just like, oh my gosh, why have I stopped using this? I actually had to repurchase it. I decided to repurchase it because I saw it was on sale at Meijer's when I went the other day. So, I don't know if y'all saw my other video where I was testing out the Clarisonic with the Real Techniques brush. Oh, where is it? This one. And I was like doing a standoff, and I mean, I still really like this brush, but I've been trying to use this Clarisonic with other types of foundation. Hold on, I'm just gonna go and start blending my face. I've been trying to use this Clarisonic with different kinds of foundations to like find a way to like make this work, because I was like so upset that this wasn't working the way that I wanted it to work. But then I've been watching more videos on using the Clarisonic foundation brush, and they were saying that if you use a more of a liquid foundation with it instead of like more of a cream kind, then it goes on better and you need to not use as much product. Knowing me, I'm still gonna use a lot of product, but as long as I can blend it out on my face. So, but I already feel like this foundation is blending so much better on my face than the other foundation I was using when I was testing both of those, which I was using the Maybelline Superstay, like the 24-hour full coverage one. I mean, I know it's not perfect. And I never put foundation under my eyes because I'm always going to put concealer there. But I am going to use a sponge and like blend out some more because I feel like I could use some more coverage in some areas. Y'all, look what I did to my sponge. I'm so mad that I did this. I cleaned all of my sponges and all of my brushes yesterday, which is like Christmas, you know? It's like, oh yes, all my brushes are clean and they're so soft and fluffy. But some like foundation wasn't coming off on this. And so I'm actually not biting my nails right now. I'm so proud of myself. But I have longer nails and I was like trying to like scrub some foundation off of it. And look what I did. I'm so mad at myself that I did this, but so I'm just not going to use that side. I'm going to use the other side, and I just put a little bit of this foundation on there so that way it doesn't really like soak up any extra foundation and just blend this out a little bit more. Like, I probably don't need to be pressing this on my face as much as I am, but it just like, it feels so nice. I don't want to stop. I'm so happy. Ugh. It makes me feel so good. Okay. Looking like a ghost. Looking like a ghost. Cool. I don't want to use Shape Tape today. I think I'm going to use Colourpop Concealer. Now, I need to get the white concealer from LA Girl because... Okay, this isn't the lightest shade from Colourpop, but this is the second lightest shade, and so I was like, oh, maybe it won't be so bad. This concealer is still too dark for me, probably like significantly, and it oxidizes, so I'm like... I just use the white, you know, lightener foundation. Yeah, Jules, you totally know what you're talking about. I feel like whenever I do my makeup, I always look crazy. But, like, I feel like I know what I'm doing. I don't know. Like, yes, I am putting white. Literally white all over my face. It's fine. Like, see? It's dark on my face. But I like this, I like the consistency of this, the ColourPop concealer. And I'm worried that even if I were to get the lightest shade that they have, I don't know if it would be light enough for me. Because your girl is, she's nice and ghostly. I either have to wear the lightest foundation that a line has or they don't have my shade. Like, that's basically how it is. And it's a little sad because there is a lot of foundation that I cannot... wear. Like, I cannot wear, I really wanted to try the Too Faced 4 in This Way foundation, and they didn't have a light enough shade for that. I was just, it's always so sad when I can't wear foundation. Do y'all remember how I was telling you in my BoxyCharm video that this sheds? It literally just shed on my own face. I wonder if I should make my nose look like a lightsaber again. Zooming. This isn't blending out very well. I feel like this is looking really weird on camera. But it doesn't look weird in person. I mean, obviously my eyes look kind of weird because they don't have foundation on them yet. There. I think I look a little more even now. I don't know. There's like a lot of concealers that people talk about that they're like, oh, they don't crease under the eyes very quickly, or they don't crease at all. And I feel like literally every concealer I have ever tried creases on me, like, almost instantly. Like, I don't know if it's because of the way my eyes are. I don't know. So, I always gotta, like, do that, and then, like, immediately push it under there. So that way it doesn't crease. And I just want to, like, do it right there, because I don't want to set my whole face quite yet. I feel like this is, like, a really cute filming angle where you can see everything. But, like, just right there. I don't understand. I don't understand my eyes. I don't understand my anything. I'm going to be setting with my Peach Perfect Too Faced Mattifying Powder, which is my favorite. If you have not tried it, it is good. It is good. It's good. As long as you don't, if you don't mind, like, things that smell, like, that are, like, heavily scented, I feel this might bother you. Like, I don't think this is something that my best friend could use. I wasn't even mad about that because it also tastes really good. Grease-tastic. That's how to make everything cool. Just throw tastic at the end of every word, which is something that I sadly do. I don't know why I do it. Fantastic. Bacon-tastic. Because bacon is always on my mind, so it's like one of the first things I say. But it's so clean. Oh, it feels so nice. Oh my god. Hey Jules, I wonder if you're using too much powder. Probably not. So, foundation base is done. Except for now I want to take it off my lips. Because, I mean, it's kind of a cute look, but not like the look I'm going for right now. Foundation lips. Wasn't that like a trend? Like, in the 90s or something? Or, like, your lips were basically, like, the same color as your face? Is that a thing? Or am I making that up? Eh, it's good enough. We're putting on lipstick later. Okay. Sorry, I'm just trying to, like, clean up my mess so that way I am not mad at the end of this video. Okay, so next I'm gonna work on some brows. Have you, like, not moved? She's not even listening to me. She don't even care about me. She didn't care. I think she just likes the sound of my voice, and that's why she wants to be in my videos. You know, Bailey is, like, she's a really good dog. She has been with me for over 5 years. I got her when she was a puppy. And I got her when I was living in Kansas. Oh, I am using the Anastasia Dip Brow in shade Blonde on a, this is just like an e.l.f. brush. I want to say this is like the eyeshadow brush. I don't know. The thing is gone. But so I got Bailey when I was living in Kansas, and we lived there for maybe a year and a half together. And then we moved to Texas again. Well, she moved to Texas for the first time, but I moved back. And then we lived in Texas, and now we're in Michigan together. This homegirl's been through a lot. She's been, even though we lived in Texas for a period of time, we did move houses a lot. And honestly, like, if anyone ever meets her, they're, like, instantly her new best friend. She loves people. She thinks she's human. And sometimes she gets on my last nerve, but I just love her, and she just is so sweet sometimes. Like, right now I feel like she's just being so sweet just by, oh mommy, I just want to be near you while you talk and film a video and do your makeup. And then a part of me also thinks that she's here because she thinks I might use one of my makeup brushes on her, because she actually likes to be brushed with a makeup brush. She's so silly.
She has a designated brush. I don't use my brushes on her because that would be scary.
If this looks like a dark brow for you, this is normal for me. And I feel like I used to do my brows a lot lighter and I didn't like the way that they looked as much when I was done with my makeup, so I always do them a little darker. And since, you know, I'm so pasty white, they look extra dark on me. Even though this is the lightest shade that Anastasia has for her dip brow, which I'm not super happy about, but I'm making it work. Okay, and this is just the Brow Power, right? Yeah, Brow Power It Cosmetics that we got in a BoxyCharm. Look at me using my products that I got in my box. I'm so proud of myself. But I legit like this pencil a lot. But I don't know if I will repurchase it, but I mean, it's good. And then I recently added this to my eyebrow routine. This is Make Me Brow by Essence, and this is also in the lightest shade that they have, Blonde. This is my life. Why do I do this to myself? And I'm wearing a white shirt so this can get all over it. Hold on. Hold, please. Anyway, continued. Here we go. We're just gonna put this in my brows. And, like, I just think this helps keeps them in place a little bit better. It's not anything too crazy. I feel like it helps emphasize like the individual hairs, so I really like using it in the front of my brow instead of it making it look like just like a block, you know. Ooh, brows are done. This is my Too Faced Shadow Insurance. I'm dropping everything. Like, this is not like normal for me, or maybe it is and I just don't realize it, and I'm noticing it more now that I'm like sitting down to film, but it's fine. This is gonna be such a fun video to edit because I get to see all the cool faces I make while I do my makeup and all the weird things that happen on my eye. Oh God. This was probably not the greatest idea, but since I made a huge mess of my eye, I'm actually gonna get some micellar water and a cotton pad and just like take this shit off. Cause I'm pissed, and I put a little bit of eyeshadow on it and it was not coming off. So we're just gonna take this off. It's gonna be fine. You live and learn. I love how these things don't normally happen to me. They usually only happen when I'm trying to film stuff. It's fine. Yeah, guys, subscribe to my channel. I'm so upset. Okay, now we're gonna go back in with that shadow insurance. I'm gonna try it again. Go in with a different powder instead as well. I think I'll just use Coty Airspun in the translucent color. The fuck? Y'all see this? What is... What is my life right now? So upset that this is going so wrong. Now that I think I've gotten this to where I can manage it, we're gonna start with eyeshadow now. We're gonna be going in with my Morphe Dare to Create palette. I'm really just gonna start here and probably work my way down some transition shades. I'm just gonna be using a Morphe M441 to start out. Just a fluffy blending brush. This is so therapeutic. Okay, I'm gonna go into that shade right next to it. I really don't want to pick that palette up because it's so big and show you guys, but it was the transition shade right next to the first one I used. Okay, and it was on the end, so you should know which one I'm going in. Oh yeah, there's also names. The first one was called Bear and the second one was called Canvas. Oh, I'm gonna be so pro one of these days. This is so not
Oh. So now I'm going to grab another smaller, it's a blending brush. It's the Morphe M433. Ta-da! It's still a fluffy blending brush, but it's not as fluffy as the M441. And I'm just going to keep that a little bit lower, but still in the crease. And then I'm going to the shade next to it called Cinder. This is how I do my makeup every morning, except for the fact that I've been messing up a lot. I'm like, what makeup look do I want to do today? I don't know, like these colors right here, I'll show you. These colors right here are like calling to me right now. And I'm like, I think I want to use those. So they're a little darker than I'm typically go for, but that's okay. I'm still gonna do it. Okay, so we'll just kind of keep this where it's at right meow. And then I'm going to go to a even smaller blending brush. I'm just going to use this like an e.l.f. $1 brush. And I'm going to go into this shade right here called Passion. It's so pretty. And it's not like, well, I'm also not digging my brush into it, but it's not going on like too dark. Blender, 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 life away. I think I'm just gonna use that same brush and go into the color right next to it. This one right here. And it is called Forever. Ooh. I think I wanna keep this mostly on the outer crease and kind of fluff it into my lid a little bit. I tell you guys, Morphe shadows have, I feel like they've gotten so much better ever since the Jaclyn Hill palette came out. Granted, I have only been wearing makeup, wearing makeup for about a year now, and I only purchased one Morphe palette before I bought the Jaclyn Hill palette. And, like, I think that's why I didn't purchase another one before the Jaclyn Hill palette came out, because I wasn't, like, super impressed with the palette that I got. I got the coffee palette, which is, like, mostly browns, which is, you know, the area that I live in normally for my eye looks. But, yeah, I just wasn't, like, super, super impressed. So, then I got the Jaclyn Hill palette and I was like, ooh, this is awesome. And then they came out with this palette and it's, I think it was a seasonal palette, so it was limited edition. And so many people were raving about it and I was like, okay, I guess I gotta get it. So I did. I think I want to put just a little bit more on this outer edge here. I'm like kind of intimidated by these colors. They're so pretty and like I want to not be intimidated by color. Like, I really wanted to get the Morphe 35B palette, which is, like, the one with all of the bright colors, because I feel like maybe if I got that, I would use brighter colors, at least, like, a couple colors out of that palette every now and again, but who knows. Okay, next I'm going to grab a Morphe M167, which is just a flat packing brush, and I think I want to get the color Create, which is like this, it's like a fuchsia color. Look at that and see what it does right here. Now, I will say, I'm using all mattes right now, and this wouldn't be a look that I would normally do without shimmer. It's gonna have shimmer, so don't worry. I need to grab a clean brush because I just got shadow under my eye. Jules, all of your brushes are clean. Why are you fumbling through them? Honestly, I probably will just like incorporate that into my eye look later because it's fine. So I think I'm actually gonna dip into my Jaclyn Hill palette because the shimmers that are in this palette, like, typically, okay, so this is, I didn't realize this, so, okay, take a good look at this palette, and I'm gonna set it down because I don't want it to dominate my face when I'm talking. But so about this palette, and I was like, oh, it has so many colors and it's so pretty. But what I didn't notice when before I purchased this palette, I realized this after I purchased it, that there's like no highlight shades in this. Why I didn't realize this, I don't know. So, I think this palette's great, and I don't really do dark eyes, so I feel like I have to use it as a companion palette. But I think I am going to dip into my Jaclyn Hill palette, and I think I want to go into this color right here, which is called Little Lady. I'm so smart, look at me. Oh, and I'm going to be using that same Morphe M167. I got the Jaclyn Hill palette on the first release because I woke up and I was like, oh, hey, the Jaclyn Hill palette is coming out today. And then I woke up and it was like a couple minutes till it was going to be released. And I just happened to get it the first time around. I knew that it was going to be good before everyone else got their hands on it, so I knew that if I didn't get it while it was hot, that it would sell out, in which I was right, but I'm glad that they ended up making it a permanent product in the Morphe line, because I feel like this palette is too good to not be permanent. I feel like they're just going to make so much money from this palette, just having it all the time, than having it be limited edition. I think this is turning out okay, but I just think I want a little bit more pigment in the pink shade, so I'm just gonna spray it with some rose water spray. See if that helps any. And it does, without fail. The shimmers are my favorite. I don't dislike the mattes, I just really like the shimmers in this palette. I'm just going to do like eyeliner and stuff, and then I will do my bottom lash line a little bit later, because I feel like the times that I actually done my lower lash line before I've done eyeliner and mascara, it always turns out to be like way more dramatic than what I want. So I'm going to be using this NYC. I love this eyeliner so much that I have rubbed off the name for it, but this is what it looks like in the packaging. Yes, this is my backup because I love this eyeliner so much. I would do buy it in more than one pack when I buy them on Amazon. So this is my backup. And I think I'm going to try to do eyeliner on camera. And if it gets too long, then I'll just cut it out and I'll be like, welcome back. And I particularly like this eyeliner because it has a brush tip and not a felt tip on it. Sometimes the felt tip can be a little too harsh. Should we wing it out today? I think we should. I tell you guys, wings used to be so intimidating to me. And I am in no way saying that I am an expert at doing winged liner. But I used to like text one of my friends and I'd be like, I love the way winged eyeliner looks, but it's so intimidating to me. And then my friend is actually the one that recommended this eyeliner to me, that I should try it because it helped made her winged eyeliner. So Becky, I'm gonna give you a shout out here real quick. My girl Becky from California. We'll go with that today. It's gonna be fine. Now the real trick is making them even. They're never even. No matter what I do. It's fine. I feel like that's gonna be my catchphrase. It's fine. We'll just make it work. Okay. Lashes. Which is actually my favorite part. I love me some lashes. Not my actual lashes. My false eyelashes. I feel like I want to do a dramatic lash today. I mean, why not? Why wouldn't I? Then I have like two packs of like the Demi Wispies, Ardell, and then I just bought two packs of the regular Wispies. These are the best. If you are like just wanting to get into lashes, the Wispies are good. They're my favorite. Except for don't get these. Don't get these. I have not had luck with these. No. Okay. Okay. I talk to myself a lot. I mean, I know, I guess I'm technically talking to myself while filming this video, but I feel like just on a daily basis, I talk to myself, and I feel like some people look at me like I'm crazy, but I'm gonna just keep doing me. This is just a Revlon eyelash curler. I just got this because my other one was breaking and it was like curling my lashes the wrong way. And by the way, if you have made it this far in this video, I am so happy because I already know this video is going to be like hella long. I mean, we're not even done with the eyes yet. Okay, guys, I still gotta do the rest of my face. I'm just gonna be using this Essence, it's Lash Princess. I don't know what, there's different colors, and I don't know what the colors mean, but I think I got purple because Tati told me to. I feel like most of my makeup decisions are because Tati told me to. Which, today is, so just to give you guys some perspective on what today is, oh my god. Today is February 26th, Monday, and Tati just talked about on her video today that came out today that her makeup line is going live on Friday. I am so excited. I love her so much. I think in a lot of ways she is me. Because I can't remember if she is celiac or not, but she has to eat gluten-free or whatever, and I have weak positive celiac, so which means I can't eat gluten, so I also have to eat gluten-free. So, and not only that, but there's just like a lot of other things where I'm like, I feel like I can relate to Tati. She's dramatic, like me. I can relate. So anyway, I just really like her because she's relatable. I guess that's all I'm trying to say. So I am going with these, I believe these are Ardell's 113s. They're a little bit more dramatic than my Ardell Wispies that I typically wear, but we'll see. But today, I just got this lash glue maybe on Friday. Like today's Monday, so maybe I got it on Friday. Might have gotten it the day before, but this is the Girls With Attitude Hypoallergenic Brush-On Lash Adhesive. And I've only worn this lash glue twice, and I really like it. So I think I'm going to have a video about this lash glue. Either, I think I'm going to have it posted before this one. So, but it is white, and it is hypoallergenic, which that's the problem I always have with lash glue, is it actually makes my eyes burn. But I love lashes so much, so this thing is the bomb. This device, I would really suggest getting one if you like are interested in getting into lashes. It has made my life so much easier. It never ceases to amaze me, the difference between lashes. Oh, I just thought of another thing that happened the other day. So, you know, I was telling you guys, I went to a couple concerts a couple nights ago. And Jeffree Star was actually at one of the concerts that I was at the other night. And sadly, I'm not a crazy person and didn't like run up to him and be like, oh my god, like we need to take a picture together. I also do YouTube, blah, blah, blah. Like I didn't do any of that. I'm not the kind of person who would do that. But I did see that he tweeted that he was there, and I did tweet something to him. and be like, yo, I'm here too. But who knows if he actually even saw it. It was the Paris concert in Grand Rapids. God, these lashes are so long. I love it. They are like basically touching my eyebrows. So do you remember in the beginning of the video where I was like, my eyebrows look so dark? Well, do they look dark still with my eyelashes like this? Or with my eyeshadow? Probably not. Okay, so I guess we'll just move on to the rest of my face. After I put everything away. Since, like I said, I don't want to make this look like a crazy mess at the end when I'm done filming this video. But I'm going to dip into my Shade Light palette. My favorite. And where's that new contour brush I just got? Okay, so let me show you guys. The brush I was using before was this e.l.f. contour brush, and it was like really, really blunt. Is that the right word? Yeah. And it was, it would just create a harsh line, and it was sometimes a little bit harder to blend out. But I got this brush, which is also an e.l.f. brush, but it is curved, and it's like, I don't know, it's just, it's so pretty, and it's much softer. I really like it. So I've been using that for contour lately.
Love it.
I'm going to dip into these two because you don't want it to be too crazy. This is where my RBF comes in. I swear, some people tell me I have RBF and then other people are like, what are they talking about? You don't have RBF. And I'm like, okay. You lying. I know I have RBF. I have seen candid photos of myself enough to see that I have resting bitch face. I am aware. So, like, if I ever look mad while filming, just know that I'm not. I will, if I'm mad, I feel like I would say something. But if I look pissed, it's just my face, okay? It's just my face. I'm sorry. But sorry, not sorry, it's my face. I'll probably put a card up here of how to make your double chin disappear, which is basically what I'm working on right now. Man, just rubbing clean brushes all over your face just feels so nice. I'm just gonna dip in with a Luxe 660, which I think I got in an Ipsy when I still had that. Oh, and this, I'm dipping into the lightest shades. And we'll bronze. This is my favorite brush to rub all over my face. It is just a crown brush. I don't know what the name is. I think I also got this in an Ipsy. This, I don't even know if it's for bronzer, but I just love using this brush all over my face. So I'm just gonna be using Butter Bronzer. This is the light bronzer. Warm up my face and also help blend out contour as well. Okay, so now that I have blended to as much as I really care to blend, if I'm being completely honest, let's grab a blush brush. And I've just been using this Flawless Face Brush by e.l.f. Honestly, this thing keeps breaking and I keep hot gluing it back together because I just can't let it go. I think I'm going to use Milani Luminiso. Why not? So this is what it looks like right here. And it is so pretty. Really? Don't want to do too much because my eyes are already pink. Okay, that's it for blush. And then what highlight should we do today, guys? What highlight? Okay, I'm being so good. Sorry, it's got crap all over it. But this is a highlight that I got in a BoxyCharm. I don't know. It's really pretty. It looks really pink, but it doesn't show up too pink on me, but it's called Rose Gold.
And we're just going to use that on, I think I'll use that on a Morphe M530. So I don't need it to be like super defined, I guess. I will say, like, always trying to find a highlight that doesn't show up like a weird color on me is hard. Being so fair. So I'll do this. I use this brush just to get like a glow going on. And then I go in with this other brush, which I'll show you in just a minute, to kind of like make it more defined in like certain areas. So this brush also, I think I got this in an Ipsy. I got tons of brushes in Ipsy. This is called Bogachis. I don't know if you're going to be able to read it, but it's just an illuminator. Sorry, was that upside down? Sorry, that was upside down. So if you can read that, that's what it is. It's just an illuminator brush. So I just grabbed this brush and just concentrate it more here and then blend it out. I've really been struggling with finding the right highlight brush. Doing a lightsaber nose. I love it. Which I actually just found out that I'm now going out. My stepmom is coming into town and we're gonna go out to eat. So now I get to go out looking like this. Yay! Okay, so now I think we're gonna go back to my lower lash line. Let me see. I'm gonna grab this. This is just like a really small $1 e.l.f. brush. Man, these were like my OG brushes. And I'm just gonna dip into probably this shade right here. The shade called Passion. I honestly don't think I want to add any other shadow down there. I kind of like it. I can't like move on without doing some inner corner highlight and brow bone highlight, so I'm just going to use that same highlight. I don't even know why I put it away. Sorry, I'm trying to find a brush. I'm just going to use this Luxie 207. Sure, yeah. Put that in the inner corner. Feel like it brings it all together. As if I'm not shiny enough, let's just put it everywhere else. And then I want to add some mascara to my lower lash line. And does this make me extra? I don't know if it does, but I use two different mascaras, one on my, you know, top lashes, one on my bottom lashes. So I like to use one that's not so clumpy on my bottom lashes because I don't want them to like look like this. I want them to look like this. I got this in an Ipsy and I haven't repurchased it yet, but it's the It Cosmetics Superhero mascara. I feel like it says that it's volumizing, but it's not super volumizing to my lower lashes. But if it just doesn't make them clump together. Sorry, I had to add a little bit more lash glue in the middle because they were coming up. I guess I just didn't add enough. I didn't have any problems the past couple days when I was wearing this lash glue with it coming off and the flipping up in the middle. I didn't have that problem, but I am today. Okay, here's my, this is what I'm like literally the worst at, picking lipstick to go with my eye look. Do I want to go monochromatic? Do I want to go different? Do I want to go nude? What do I want to do? Yeah, I think I'm just going to go monochromatic just to make it easier on myself. Okay, so I'm going to use a lip liner because I am so not good at doing my lips. I think I'll just use this. This is a Wet n Wild gel lip liner. This is the shade Gone Burgundy. It's not like a perfect match, but at least it'll make my lips somewhat similar in color to the lipstick. So we'll go with this nice diffusia. It's a liquid catsuit. And then these lip colors dry down matte, which is nice. Yeah, this is a very different look than what I normally go with. which is fun. It's fun.
And fine. It's fine.
It's fine. I think the last step is setting spray. Honestly, I don't think there's anything else I need to do. Except for maybe, like, fix my hair. I think I'm going to use my Wet n Wild, since we're just going with this trend here. This is a Wet n Wild video, obviously. It's just I'm going to use the Wet n Wild matte finish setting spray. Just spray it all over. Just going to use my fan that I got from Thailand. Fan my face. I just can't stop fanning my face. Just feels so nice. Don't you guys like how I start filming? Like, right before the sun goes down, and like when I'm done filming, the sun is down. It was so nice out today. Alright, so I guess that completes today's video of my somewhat chatty get ready with me. If you did hang around to the end, thank you so much. I feel like sometimes I can be not difficult to watch, but if anybody hangs around till then, it just makes me so happy. So I do see like how long people watch my videos, and it like tells me like the average how long people watch, and you know, it's not always the best, which is fine. But my point is to eventually get to where people will watch majority of my videos, and hopefully they won't all be this long, which I know this video is very long. So if you did hang around with me till the end, thank you. I love you. I'm just gonna go ahead and say it. I love you, because not everyone would do that, obviously. But if you did make it to the end, go ahead and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!